Mega Badger, I love yours.
Tell us about yourself.
Hey, my name is Joel Christiansen. My company is called Dog Theory, and my game is called Disaster Blaster for Xbox Live Indie Games.
Now, tell us about your background.
My background is I started out as a modeler and texture artist, working for a couple of different small to mid-sized game companies. I did that for about 7 years. I've got like 3 years experience teaching game art and design, and I've been an indie developer for like 5 years now.
What is your favorite part of being an indie developer as opposed to being a AAA?
I would have to say both the creative freedom and the challenge that comes with designing something that is your own idea. Like, working on your own idea is a privilege. It's also like a great, great challenge. It's very, you know, you have a vision in mind, and achieving that is, I find it to be much more difficult and also more rewarding than contributing to a larger project.
What are the challenges you face of being an indie developer?
There are a lot, but for me, like, one thing is, besides just like getting the game out there and getting people to know about it, you know, one of the main challenges is, you know, how do I add certain features to my game that, you know, maybe aren't something that I really have a lot of technical ability in doing. Like, I might want to add a level editor to my game. Okay, well, you know, how do I do that? I mean, for me, as kind of I'm kind of an artist designer. That's my background. That I'm not, like, I really don't have a lot of hardcore programming skills. So for me, it's not always easy to achieve. You know, people will say, oh, hey, in Super Meat Boy, like, when you finish a level, it shows you ghosts of all your past failed attempts and like a storm of meat going through the level. Can you do that? And I'm like, maybe. So besides all the challenges of, you know, kind of being your own boss, managing your time, getting your game out there, marketing yourself and stuff, just like the technical challenge of achieving like what you want to is huge. So pick your challenge. I mean, there are many there are many that indies face up against.
What sort of adventures have you had as an indie developer, sort of exploring conventions or getting your game noticed?
Well, this is like the second one I've done. This is Game Dallas 2014. I also did Captivate in Austin last year, 2013. So it was amazing just like connecting with other designers and seeing what they're working on. It's really, really cool to see like what in Texas, what the community is doing. And you know, everybody's super supportive. It's something like, you know, going the first time, I was just like, dude, I don't know. Like, if I'm gonna, I don't know if my game's gonna look like the worst game here or what, you know? But, you know, just putting yourself out there, going and meeting other people and kind of connecting with the community, it's amazing how cool and supportive everybody is. So, adventures, I mean, just playing other games, watching people play your game that you've designed is always a great adventure, and usually they're not afraid to tell you what they think about it. Like, other designers especially, I notice, would be like, yeah, bro, like, what you need to do here is this, and they'll just kind of, like, tell you what's wrong with it. So that's something I really look for. Like, I try to get video of them playing while they're doing it the first time especially. So, I mean, I always come back from a conference like this with like a mental list of things like I have to absolutely fix, like this, because everybody like missed it at the show. So it's a great testing opportunity, great opportunity to socialize and like connect with others. It's just an awesome thing, and every chance I get to come to one of these, I do it.
Now tell us about your game.
My game is called Disaster Blaster. It is a minimalist arcade-style shooter for Xbox Live Indie Games. The idea came from just inspiration from games like Galaga and Centipede, like some of my favorite arcade classics, and wanting to do a game that had like similar action, and like also the same kind of abstraction where you don't really, things are blocks or like abstract shapes, and you don't really know what they are. You kind of have to fill in mentally like where you are and what's happening in the game. A lot like reading a book compared to watching a movie. You know, you kind of like fill in mentally while you read. So, you know, I wanted to do something that had an arcade, a level of difficulty, a good arcade action that reminded me of these older games, and also like was kind of abstract and a little bit experimental.
And what sort of things do you hope for players to keep coming back to the game?
I think like the challenge is a key thing. It's a really hard game, and a lot of players who are fans of arcade games or who are hardcore console players really like a challenge. So I think just that is going to be, it's something that's going to attract a lot of players. If they, you know, your friend tells you, this game is hard as nails, bro. Like, I couldn't, like, I stayed up till 3 and I could not crack this level. That's going to make people want to play. It makes me want to play it.
Yeah.
So I think that's one thing. It's got a lot of, I think a lot of replay value. It's a non-linear game, so you don't have to play every level. You can always choose a different path. That's something that, like, with games like Mega Man, I always enjoyed, being able to choose the order you fight the robots. So, you know, hopefully it's a simple game. It's, you know, obviously made by one guy. It doesn't have, like, the grand scope of, you know, it's not World of Warcraft or anything. But, you know, hopefully enough depth and enough interest and challenge to kind of... you know, for players to get what they want out of it and to keep them coming back.
And what sort of post-launch ideas do you have, like involving the game or any other game?
Well, I'm doing right now a booster, so you can click on Dog Theory Games, you can go and click on the link, and you can get your signature Disaster Blaster custom graphic hoodie. It's just something as, it's basically crowdfunding, but I'm more, doing it more for like awareness for the game than to kind of try to get money out of it. I hope to get like a little bit of money, but you know, post-release, I do plan to do some other platforms. I'm going to do a PC release of the game, and I'm looking at mobile also, like doing you know, touch controls set up for tablets. I don't want to like promise it to anyone. I hope I can, you know, I hope I can basically overcome the technical hurdles to making that happen, but so other platform releases coming up in like the next 6 months or a year is what I hope to do. And obviously interviews, any kind of like, if I can ever get like a review of the game out there or anything, like all of that, I want to try to do as much as I can.
So what's your thoughts on Industry Giants?
Industry Giants? Like EA? What are my thoughts on it? Well, I used to teach game development and design, and I would ask this question in class. I would say, like, guys, do you think like the age of the AAA is like is almost over? Do you think these are like the dinosaurs, like are gonna vanish off the earth? You know, and I don't necessarily think they're going anywhere. I think that they'll. I think really, it's been discussed a lot in the indie community. Like, are indies are better? No, like AAA is better. You know, and I think really there's room for both. I mean, there are more people playing games than ever. There are more games than ever. And there's really room for, you know, any huge budget game, and there's room for any small game to find an audience. So, I mean, I think peaceful coexistence is the future for industry giants as well as indies.
If someone were to get into the gaming industry, what is your advice?
As working for a company and like a game studio? Or as an indie?
I guess as an indie, because this is what...
My advice as an indie is the same advice you'll get from every other indie developer, which is finish your game. Finish it. Finish the game. Like, that's the advice. Like, that's the best. I'm still trying to follow that advice. So, without finishing your game, what can you do? You know, you have an unfinished project. You can tell people, hey, I'm making a game. I have an idea for a game. I wrote a design document for a game. Look, it's awesome. And they're gonna just say, where's the game? Like, I want to play this. So yeah, you basically have to finish it. That's the only real advice. I mean, don't wait for someone to help you do it. Like, stop trying to learn about how to do it. Just go make the game. Jesse Schell gives the same advice in his great book, Book of Lenses, The Art of Game Design. Basically, hey Jesse Schell, I want to make a game. And his answer is, why are you talking to me? Go, now. Like, begin making it right now. Don't even finish this conversation. So I would offer that same advice, you know, pull the trigger, just do it now. And you will pick up knowledge and things you need along the way.
All right, well, I guess that wraps up this interview.
Thank great, I appreciate time. It. Thank you.
Go to www.dogtheorygames.com to keep updated with Disaster Blaster or other Dog Theory games. And be sure to check out booster.com/Disaster Blaster and purchase your hoodie today.